Well, the pilgrims arrived and they didn't know what to do. The land was all undeveloped because the Indians hadn't done any work. It was all weeds, no sprinklers, nothing. Just nothing. They couldn't get anything to grow or even make shelter before the harsh winter came. In the pilgrims' darkest hour, when all was lost, along came Squanto. The following autumn, the pilgrims invited the Indians to a feast to thank them for all their kindness. The feast was the perfect opportunity for the pilgrims to try out their new exploding corn. Our forefathers took their land, and it was good. And now, how about a champagne toast?
To the Smiths. They gave me their old curtains.
I can't wait to see the look on my brother's face when he sees these Manola Blahniks I got for the turkey.
Oh, Stan. Our first Thanksgiving since Haley ran off with Jeff. It just won't be the same without our little girl. There is still a week. Maybe they'll come back.
She's not coming back, Francine. In fact, she's dead to me for marrying that loser.
Stan.
Yep, we got some HVAC running through here.
Steve, what are you doing?
Expanding my room. I'm an only child now, so I get anything I want. You have to do whatever I say because I'm all you got. And I want a bigger room! I want a closet like Big Made for Carrie in Sex and the City. I want a labradoodle and a nice camera to take pictures of us!
Steven, you are out of control, mister.
You better not behave this way when Rusty and his family get here.
If anyone has the right to complain, it's them. They don't have squat. You know what? For Thanksgiving this year, we're not going to have them come here. We're going to their gross teepee in Crap Hole, Arizona. Then you'll see how good you've got it.
What?
You heard me. And then we're going to Four Corners, where you'll get to see me breakdance in four states at once.
Oh, man! We're going to spend a whole week here? I didn't bring enough batteries for all my stuff.
Rusty!
Sorry about the elk. I found him on the side of the road.
You Indians really don't waste a thing, do you? Except for time reading the fine print on treaties.
Hop in, guys.
I call antlers up the butt. Mine called it.
You live here?
I do.
This is what Steve needs to see. Come on, let's get settled.
Stan, where are you going? That is the pump house for the fountains and pools.
Fountains and pools? Well, so then, where do you live?
Up there.
That's your house?
Well, actually, it is a replica of Augustus Caesar's summer house built into the cliffs of Cyprus. But yes, that is the long way of saying yes.
So, we're the poor family.
Whoa, somebody just got cuter.